Hi, I'm Adam Janke, Statewide Wildlife Extension Specialist here at Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. We're here today on a working farm in central Iowa to talk to you about creating wildlife habitat on working lands in Iowa. Wildlife are important for Iowans from all walks of life. They're an important source of recreation from outdoor wildlife viewing or hunting and bird watching. And they're also an important piece of our rural landscapes. The United States Fish and Wildlife Service estimates that over 750,000 people identify as active wildlife watchers in Iowa, and they spend over $700 million annually on trips and supplies for wildlife watching. Hunting is also a really popular activity in Iowa, and 253,000 residents annually participate, and they spend over $400 million in the state on hunting-related expenditures. There's lots of wildlife conservation success stories to be proud of here in Iowa. We used to have no white-tailed deer, no wild turkeys, no river otters or bobcats. Despite the number of conservation success stories for wildlife populations here in Iowa, we still have a lot of challenges. And the number one factor driving to those declines is the availability of wildlife habitat. What makes ideal wildlife habitat depends mostly on what species of wildlife you're talking about. So we find a lot of habitat in areas that we call early successional areas. Weedy, grassy, shrubby habitats on the edges of fields or in old pastures or around farm lots. And these are really important for a lot of native and introduced game birds. And then of course our forested areas are really important wildlife habitat as well for wild turkeys and white-tailed deer and all sorts of other critters. We also have important habitats in our water areas, any types of surface water in the state, and most importantly for wildlife are wetland habitats, shallow water habitats with emergent vegetation where lots of birds raise their young or use throughout the year. We also find wildlife habitat on a lot of working lands. Things like pastures and hay fields are really important nesting habitats. And also crop fields are an important food source for a lot of wildlife. They raise their young in crop fields where they can eat insects, or all winter long they'll find waste grain or residual vegetation. Historically, in the early 1900s and late 1800s, we had relatively diverse crop rotations with oats and other small grains and a lot of pasture land where we grazed livestock to pull the implements that were used in agricultural production. And we also, because of the scale of production practices, had relatively small parcels of crop fields and pastures all intermixed. And that created really good wildlife habitat. Wildlife were basically just a byproduct of our agricultural land uses. Fast forward to today, and we have a relatively reduced diversity of crop rotations in the state, with mostly corn and bean rotations, and not as much pasture ground as we did. And all of our parcels are a lot bigger, and that creates fewer areas for wildlife habitat. And today, we need to focus on sort of intentional wildlife habitat conservation measures in working landscapes. To conserve wildlife habitat in our modern landscape here in Iowa, there needs to be sort of a two-prong approach. The first step is to conserve what remains and manage what remains so we can find good quality wildlife habitat in working landscapes. The second prong to conserving wildlife habitat in working lands is to recognize that everything we do on the landscape has some sort of an impact on wildlife and wildlife habitat, and we can start to incorporate wildlife considerations into everything we're doing on the farm. Existing practices include things like nutrient management, and so just a few simple changes to practices to improve water quality can also have big impacts on wildlife habitat. Pollinator conservation. Wildlife benefit from the same types of habitats, so rich diversity of flowering plants throughout the year in woodlands, edges of fields, and in grassed areas and around fields can be really good habitat for wildlife. Precision agriculture is an area that we see a lot of potential for wildlife habitat. And areas where we're losing money are really good opportunity areas to increase wildlife habitat. So for example, a common area where profit margins are really tight are wet spots. And wet spots are a really important habitat type for a lot of birds and amphibians and reptiles. A final practice where there's a lot of potential to create wildlife habitat in working landscapes is alongside soil conservation practices. Looking at areas on the farm like highly erodible lands and taking them out of production and putting them into perennial vegetation is a really good wildlife habitat conservation measure. All these wildlife habitat conservation measures that we're talking about today also come with a lot of support from state or federal agencies with cost share or technical expertise available to implement the practices on the ground, to, in some cases, to receive rental rates for the land, and also to inform how to carry out some of these wildlife habitat conservation measurements. Landowners and producers can get help from the Natural Resources Conservation Service, or NRCS, and also we have wildlife biologists with the Iowa Department of Natural Resources. Their sole purpose is to help private landowners do wildlife habitat conservation. Here in Iowa, we have the richest soils and the best climate in the world for agricultural production. So we have a big agricultural footprint across the state. And so that means that we have any wildlife left here in Iowa. It shows that small actions by individual landowners and producers can have a big impact on the sustainability of wildlife and wildlife habitat in our state.